So hepatitis C is a virus that can cause long-term problems with adults or children, including things like liver failure and liver cancer. And although it can be a chronic issue for many people, in pregnancy, one of the things we're particularly concerned about is transmission of the virus from the mother to the baby, as well as hepatitis C is associated with other risks like preterm birth, babies who are too small, and intrahepatic cholestasis of pregnancy. And we know that we can cure people by treating. And so the standard of care for most patients has been to refer them for treatment to start after they give birth, or treatment in the early postpartum period. And many programs have made great progress in treating hepatitis C by these referrals and linkages to care. Until recently, the options were really just treatments before or after pregnancy. So I think there's two big challenges to this. One is that in the US, unfortunately, many women lose access to healthcare in the postpartum period. If you are on Medicaid and a state without postpartum Medicaid extension, some people don't have healthcare after 60 days postpartum. And for other people, the burdens of parenting take precedent over one's own healthcare. And so it's hard to remain engaged in healthcare in the postpartum period. And the second reason why treating in the postpartum period might be inadequate is it doesn't allow us the opportunity to potentially prevent transmission to babies. By treating mom during pregnancy and potentially curing her hepatitis C, we think there's a good chance we can eliminate the chance of transmission of hepatitis C from the mother to the baby. The newest drugs, which are called direct-acting antivirals, have been studied outside of pregnancy for a number of years now. Patients take a single pill once a day for between 8 and 12 weeks in most cases. There's a few different types out there. Some are newer and some have been around a little bit longer. And we do a series of labs before they start treatment, during treatment, and then afterwards to see how they're responding, to look for side effects, and then ultimately to see if their virus level in their body goes away. This is a huge advancement. Probably one of the biggest public health advancements of this decade is going to be curing hepatitis C. And curing pregnant people is incredibly important, absolutely necessary to eliminating hepatitis C in the United States and beyond. We've been counseling patients for a long time about the opportunity to start treatment after they give birth. But in 2020, we started treating more patients because they were really interested in getting this cure for themselves now, while they have access to care, while they're coming in regularly for prenatal visits, and because they too hoped that it would prevent their babies from getting hepatitis C. So we've now treated a number of patients, some who are living with HIV as well as hepatitis C, and some who don't have HIV. And we've had some great experiences with getting cure for those moms. So our program's goal is ultimately to make moms and babies healthier. We want that moms with hepatitis C can achieve this cure so they can live the healthiest life they possibly can. We also want to prevent babies from getting hepatitis C so that they live long and healthy lives. But we also really think that it's fundamental that pregnant people be included in treatments and research programs about hepatitis C. We think that it's a long historical injustice that pregnant people have often been excluded, and now it's time to pay attention to pregnancy as a window of opportunity for treatment, for cure, for research, and because it allows pregnant people to have autonomy in their decision-making about their care. It is key to include pregnant people in programming and research around infections during pregnancy. Lessons we've learned from COVID, for example, is that pregnant people were often left out of the vaccine trials. And so doctors have to figure out how to counsel their patients based on the best knowledge we have. But when pregnant people are left out of treatment, whether it's hepatitis C, COVID, or anything else, it puts pregnant people and their babies at risk. And we want to fix that situation.